So I said on my last update video that I was sorry for not uploading for 4 months, and it's been 8 months since I've uploaded that video. So I'm very sorry about that. The reason why I was gone for so long is because I was in college, I was having a bit of a hiatus, I was in a little bit of a slump, I was too busy with school, and I was honestly in a little bit of a depression, but I've recovered quite a bit, so now I feel like I'm ready to continue making videos. I genuinely enjoyed making the top 10 animated shorts that I made because I was sort of speaking from the heart and saying what I really, really liked about those short films, so I said, why not make one about animated features? So a question that I asked myself recently was, Cameron, why are you majoring in visual effects instead of animation since you like animation so much? Well, the reason is because animation is hard. While visual effects only really uses the mind in order to make incredible effects, animation requires both the mind and your hands, and I don't trust my hands with that kind of work. Animation takes genuine artistic genius in order to pull off correctly, and I don't have that kind of artistic genius. I do think I'm pretty good at visual effects, but that's all I'm ever going to be. So that's kind of why I don't want to pursue animation. I would love to direct animated movies, but to actually animate that would be incredibly difficult, and I don't have that kind of talent. So that being said, I do love animated movies. They're some of my favorite movies in general because they can be so charming and so ambitious in general. So I just wanted to talk about my favorites. So here are my top 10 animated movies. So similarly to my animated short films video, this isn't gonna be like a 10 is the worst and then number one is the best. It's just gonna be all of my favorites in a non-specific order. But before I get into that, I'd like to make some honorable mentions, just simply for their animation style alone. So the first one is Kubo and the Two Strings. It's one of the most beautifully animated movies ever. It mixes stop-motion animation with CG seamlessly, and it just looks incredibly good. It's unbelievable. But the reason why it's not one of my favorites is just because I think the story is a little bit lacking in that sense. I do think that Kubo and the monkey are so good together. They work so well, their dialogue is fantastic, but the beetle isn't really a good character. Plus, I feel like the story is a little bit all over the place with them trying to find three items. I feel like that's almost like a TV show kind of thing that would work, but not necessarily in a movie. The second one is Loving Vincent. This is by far the most ambitious animated project I have ever seen. It's an entire animated movie done in the style of Vincent Van Gogh. And you can see by the footage that it's just unbelievable. Yes, every frame in that movie is a painting. Literally every frame of painting. But the reason why it's not one of my favorites is just, it's so boring. It really is. Like, I saw the trailer when it first came out many years ago, and I thought, this is gonna be a perfect movie. There's no way I'm not gonna like it. And I don't like it. It's really boring. The animation is gorgeous, but just the storyline is so flat. The characters aren't interesting. And I just, you know, it's not good. I'm sorry. But the animation is. So what I would recommend doing is just muting the movie and then putting on some trippy music in the background, and then you'll love it a lot more. And my final honorable mention is Garden of Words. Garden of Words is the most beautiful foreign animated movie that I've ever seen. The realistic effects of the lighting and the rain are just unbelievable. The character animation is fantastic, but the story isn't the best. It has some great moments, but it's sort of all right overall. It's really short too. It's only like 45, 50 minutes. So just watch that when you can and you'll understand what I mean. So without further ado, here are my top 10 animated movies of all time. So the empire of animation these days is Disney, and it's always been. Disney has made classic after classic after classic, and some of them haven't stuck very well, but many of them are just unbelievable. And personally, some of my favorite animated movies are those that aren't musicals, because it doesn't necessarily have to rely on catchy tunes in order to sell itself. It has to rely on dialogue, clever writing, a good storyline, and well-developed characters. So for a Disney non-musical, I say that Treasure Planet is by far the best one. It's an adaptation of Treasure Island, and I think it's unbelievably well done. It seamlessly mixes 3D animated environments and sometimes even parts, and it mixes it incredibly with 2D character design. Plus, the story is great. It does a great adaptation of the original novel, and it's super entertaining to watch. I remember when I watched it as a kid, and I didn't necessarily like it a lot, but I watched it again recently, and I absolutely loved it. So if you want a good animated movie, that's our best bet. Now, going to the Disney musical, all right, this is a hard choice. Disney has had some unbelievable animated musicals over the past 80 years, something, probably longer. Some of my favorite Disney animated musicals include Mulan, Lion King, Tangled, and Princess and the Frog. Princess and the Frog because of the music, not necessarily because of the story. But this is sort of a controversial opinion. My favorite Disney animated musical is Hunchback of Notre Dame. The reason why I like this one so much is just because of how adult it is. It's not afraid to talk about adult themes like lust and the flaws of the Catholic Church, and it has one of the best villains in Disney history. It has some amazing lessons where you can be loved past your flaws, and I think the characters are genuinely incredibly likable, including the villain. I don't like the villain because he's a likable guy. I like the villain because of how well-written he is and just how evil he is. He's so dark and horribly hypocritical that you just can't help but love every second that he's on screen. The musical numbers in this movie aren't the best that Disney has to offer, but man, are they good. Okay, you can't even mention best animated movies without bringing up Pixar. Pixar was the OG 3D animation company that just did it perfectly. And they took a huge risk with making kids' movies instead of adult movies. Because adult movies generally sell better than kids' movies, so they're taking a huge risk with that. But they pulled it off incredibly well. So of course, two of my movies on this list are going to be Pixar movies. And the first one is Inside Out. A lot of people don't necessarily like Inside Out a lot, and I can understand why. A lot of people say it's sort of like a rehashing of Toy Story, and when you make the comparisons, it makes sense. I can see why. But the thing I love about Inside Out is it's not necessarily pretentious, but it still teaches a lot about psychology. It teaches a lot about the subconscious and about lost memories, but not only that, but it teaches the importance of negative emotions. Joy isn't the only good emotion that we can have in life. And that's an incredibly important lesson to teach kids, because it's more important to feel bad than to feel nothing at all. One of my favorite moments in movie history is when Riley comes home after she tries to run away. Each time I watch that, I just start crying my eyes out. And I did! I watched it like 10 minutes ago, and it just, it's heartbreaking. It genuinely is. And they did such a good job with the writing of this movie and the character development of this movie. And you just have to give props to Pixar for making such an amazing movie after they had sort of a low quality slump there. All right, the second Pixar movie that's a part of this list is The Incredibles. This is my favorite Pixar movie ever. I watched it recently because I was incredibly excited for The Incredibles 2. I wanted to see how the original Incredibles lived up, and it's so much better than I remembered as a kid. I would say that the animation has aged not necessarily greatly, but man, is that storyline and are the characters just so good. Each scene is an integral part of the movie. If you left out any scene in the movie, it just wouldn't work. And all the scenes work so well. The soundtrack is one of my favorite soundtracks of all time, with that big band, just incredibly exhilarating sound, and just Brad Bird kills it with this. I also think that The Incredibles has the best Pixar characters ever. Each character has very clear motivations, flaws, and struggles, and it shows them brilliantly. It's just, ugh, it's so good. I could gush for hours about how it's so good, but if you haven't seen The Incredibles already, what are you doing? All right, now let's go into the foreign movies section. What I mean foreign, I automatically mean Japanese because I haven't seen very many other foreign movies yet. But man, does Japan make some of the best foreign movies ever. And you can't mention animated foreign movies without Studio Ghibli. And this is where I pulled the nostalgia card. My favorite Studio Ghibli movie is Princess Mononoke. I remember watching it as a kid and remembering how ambitious it was and just so weird, but it made sense overall. The world is incredibly well written, and each of the characters just, they're so good. And it's one of the only anime movies where the English dub is significantly better than the original Japanese voices. I remember watching a few anime movies this year and watching the English dub, and they're not good, but the English dub of Princess Mononoke is fantastic. Particularly my favorite role in that movie was Billy Bob Thornton's role. He does a fantastic job voicing the main antagonist. And of course, Studio Ghibli has so many other classic movies out there, you just gotta see them all. All right, and this is my favorite anime movie ever. It's a recent movie, I believe it came out in 2016, and it's called Your Name. Your Name is a higher stakes version of Freaky Friday. It's where a guy and a girl switch places in life, and they gotta learn how to live each other's lives and learn more about each other. It's far more than that, but I don't want to spoil anything. But man, is this movie gorgeous. It has the same director as Garden of Words, and I was hoping that Garden of Words could have brought more to the table with its storyline and characters, but Your Name delivers. It has an art style that's almost as good as Garden of Words, with characters and storyline that just blows it out of the water. And I watched it with my sister sort of recently, and both of us just loved it, absolutely. So I can't recommend that one enough. All right, now we're going into the stop motion part, because stop motion is the hardest type of animation ever. So the first movie I'm going to talk about in the stop motion category is Fantastic Mr. Fox. Wes Anderson is the director of this movie, and he's the director of my favorite movie ever, The Grand Budapest Hotel, and he absolutely brings his style to the table seamlessly. I hear he wasn't on set as often as he could have been with the animation, but I feel like his touch is still there quite a bit. He takes Roald Dahl's novel incredibly seriously, and he gives it his own sort of comedic twist on it. And it's just a lot of lighthearted fun, and it's just so good. The performances by George Clooney, Meryl Streep are great, and I can't recommend this movie much. It's also just gorgeous. One of the reasons why I think Fantastic Mr. Fox actually looks better than Kubo and the Two Strings is because Fantastic Mr. Fox is entirely stop motion. And even though it's impressive in its own right to seamlessly mix stop motion with CG, making something entirely stop motion is so difficult to do well, and they do it incredibly well. So that's why it's on the list. And then my next movie on the list is sort of an adult movie. Many of these movies are kids' movies, and I'm not gonna lie, but this is a movie strictly for adults. It deals with adult themes, it's sort of depressing, but it's also incredibly meta, and it's fantastic. The director of this movie, Charlie Kaufman, who wrote one of my favorite movies, Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, does a fantastic job with creating Anomalisa. The thing about Anomalisa that really stands out is that one of the principles of animation is exaggeration. A term for exaggerating your own emotions is animated. So if that makes sense, when you animate, you want to exaggerate not only their emotions, but also the way that they move, with things like exaggerated physics and things like that. Animation genius Richard Williams says, "Good drawing is not copying the surface. It has to do with understanding and expression. We don't want to learn to draw just to end up being imprisoned and showing off our knowledge of joints and muscles. We want to get the kind of reality that a camera can't get. We want to accentuate and suppress aspects of the model's character to make it more vivid." And what Anomalisa does here is it takes exaggeration, throws it out the window, and replaces it with realism, and does it flawlessly. All of the characters' movements are insanely realistic, almost crossing into the uncanny valley. Plus, I thought it was going to bother me since I thought that one of the face pieces that kept the lines with the transition of the upper part of the head and the bottom part of the face, but they actually implement that into the story, and it's fantastic. Plus, it's incredibly unsettling when you think about it after you watch it. It really has sort of a theme of existentialism and unhappiness there. And it's one of the most brilliantly written animated movies that I've ever seen. So I couldn't recommend this movie enough. All right, my ninth animated movie is an animated musical, but it's not Disney. Personally, this is possibly my favorite animated musicals of all time, and it's Prince of Egypt. We all know the stereotype that Christian movies generally suck, and I agree. There have been some good ones over the years, but man, have there been some bad ones. Like a lot of bad ones. But Prince of Egypt adapts the story of Exodus from the Bible and actually makes it not only relatable, but realistic as well. The characters are so expressive and alive that it's almost unnerving, because the Bible is very vague. It doesn't necessarily tell a lot about the emotions that they're doing, unless it's very important to the story. But this movie gives each character so much soul that it's incredible. Plus, the music is chilling. The opening number, Deliver Us, I think is one of the best opening numbers in movie history. With its backup vocals and the female lead singer, it's unbelievable, and it just gives me goosebumps every time that I listen to it. Plus, it also mixes 3D animation with 2D animation, and also 3D effects. And I think the effects in this movie are incredible as well. So if you haven't seen Prince of Egypt, you gotta see it. It's incredible. Just don't watch the sequel to that. And finally, number 10. I watched this movie endlessly as a kid. I almost had it on loop, or I'd watch it just every day. And it's another movie directed by Brad Bird, The Iron Giant. I don't really have a lot to say about The Iron Giant that I haven't said 1,000 times before in this video, but this one, it's sort of nostalgic, but not only that, I just realized how unbelievably quality it is. It has a special place in my heart. It really does. It's it's amazing. And since I'm inconsistent, I'm gonna add a special number 11 that's not necessarily a part of the honorable mentions because I love this movie as well, How to Train Your Dragon. How to Train Your Dragon is the best 3D animated DreamWorks movie by far. And some people say 2 is better, but I feel like the first is better in my opinion. The reason why is because the first one focuses more on character development, and the second one focuses more on world building. And I think character development is so much more important to a movie's plot than world building. But the effects in this movie, the smoke, the fire, and the character animation is just... Not only that, but the writing is actually incredibly good, if it is a little bit cliche. You know, a boy finds an animal, he has to keep it away from everybody, because they're gonna take it away from him. But this is the best version of that cliche, by far. So yeah, those are my favorite animated movies. Let me know what your guys' favorite animated movies are. I'm sure I'm gonna get some people saying, you know, Spirited Away and Howl's Moving Castle and Toy Story are some of their favorite animated movies, and I completely agree with you, but these 10 I feel like are my personal favorite. Probably all the movies that are going to be in the comments I love equally, but all of these have a special place in my heart. All right, before I head out, I want to apologize again for being gone for 8 months. That's unbelievable, and I am going to try and upload more often. That isn't a promise, but I definitely am going to try. And like I said in the last video, I still have a project that I'm working on that I want you guys to see as soon as possible, but hopefully you'll be able to see it soon. All right, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. See you later.